बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो दैट आवर रिवीजन सेशन इज़ गोइंग ऑन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द स्टोरी द पीस ऑफ स्ट्रिंग, द थर्ड स्टोरी इन आवर स्मार्ट सिलेबस, रिटन बाय गॉय डी मापसा। एज यू हैव रेड दिस स्टोरी इन द क्लासरूम, इट्स टेक्स्ट एंड इट्स ट्रांसलेशन। नाउ जस्ट फॉर रिवीजन सेक I will give you a summary and then we will discuss the exercise. So the story starts at a marketplace. In a big hall, the people gathered to discuss their affairs about the business. They were discussing as well as they were taking a heavy meals. While discussion, a drum beater made an announcement that a purse was lost in the morning on the road to the market, and it contained 500 shillings. And he further said that the finder was requested to return it to the caretaker of the hall, public hall, and there would be a reward of 20 shillings for returning the purse because it contained business papers also. At the meanwhile, the police had arrived there. He asked about Mr. Hubbard. Mr. Hubbard was found sitting at the corner of the room, and Mr. Police officer asked him to follow him to the mayor's office. Mr. Hubbard was worried and anxious that why he was called by the mayor. When he reached at mayor's office, the mayor was very he found mayor very serious and stout person, and mayor told him that he was Mr. Hubbard was found picking up the pocketbook this morning. In this way, he accused him of stealing, of picking up the lost pocketbook about which the announcement was made. Mr. Hubbard was a very simple peasant, a countryman. He told the mayor that he was picking the piece of string because he remembered that in the morning he had picked up a piece of string from the mud, but the mayor was not ready to believe his story of the piece of string, and there was a great abusing among them for a long time. But after searching Mr. Hubbard, he left him that he would make further decision after discussing to the public prosecutor. Mr. Hubbard was shocked at this accusation. He went to the people, he showed them his pockets, and he told them the story of his piece of string, but no one was ready to accept his story, to believe upon his story. This accusation and this thing made him ashamed, and he was too much grieved of being called a liar. This thing made him ill, and he took to his bed. Within a month, he became so weak that he died in the end of the month. It was said that he kept claiming his innocence at the time of his death and saying, a piece of string, by my word of honor, I did not lie." In the delirium of his death, he was kept on claiming his innocence and died. It was said that the great flood came in that village, in its great wrath and carried away the people and all their belongings, the grave of Hubert withstood the havocs of the flood. It was engraved on his tombstone, years after his death, "Here lies the man who told nothing but truth. Here lies the man who would not prove his innocence, but the flood proved it." So it is the story and the summary of the story. And now we will see its exercise. Before coming to the exercise, let us see some difficult words which will help you to fill in the blanks as you have to do the synonyms in your paper. First, there is appetizing. Appetizing word means tempting, inviting, exciting. The next word is stout. Stout means very healthy, fat, or plump, fleshy. Astounded. Astounded means shocked, astonished, bewildered. These are the synonyms of astounded. Exasperating means irritating, angry, or annoyed. Indignation. Indignation also means annoyance, anger, rage, wrath. Public prosecutor. It is a legal official of the state or the government official. In simple words, you can say a lawyer. Curiosity. Curiosity means inquisitiveness, spirit of inquiry, or investigativeness. Rascal. Rascal means a scoundrel, villain, or a knave. Havoc. Havoc refers to destruction, devastation, damage, ruin. So these are the difficult words, important difficult words in the chapter, which will help you to solve the synonyms. Now come to the exercise. Here in the exercise, you have to choose the correct answers after reading the chapter carefully. First is the rich people gathered at a big hall to watch a show, for a discussion, to hear a lecture, for a great meal. So the right one is for a great meal. Number two, what was the public statement made by the drumbeater? Loss of the black leather pocketbook containing money and business paper. Open invitation for a dinner, to enjoy concert, sale of a building. So correct is option A, loss of black leather pocketbook containing money and business papers. Number three, Mr. Hubert was surprised and disturbed when the police officer asked him to accompany him to the police station, the mayor's office, the court, the airport. So the correct one is option B, the mayor's office. Number four, by my word of honor, I never heard of it, means that he never saw it. B, being an honorable man, he did not pick up the lost pocket object. C, an honorable person never thought of picking up a lost object. D, he never heard of the lost object. In this MCQ, we will see the second is the correct. Being an honorable man, he did not pick up the lost pocket object. Number five, what did Hubert say in the most exasperating tone? He never stole the pocketbook. He picked up a piece of string. It is nevertheless the truth of the good God, the sacred truth. D, O him, yes, he saw me pick up this string here. So the C option is correct. It is nevertheless truth of the good God, the sacred truth. Number 6. What were the feelings of Herbert when he was informed of the recovery of the lost object? He felt disgusted, triumphed, indifferent, or concerned. So the correct one is B, triumphed. Triumphant. Number 7. But he only met with incredulity. Telling the truth, lying, showing his faith, or gentleman. So here he only met with, he was believed, only met with incredulity means he was only considered a liar. So lying is the correct option. Number 8. What did the people say behind his back? Those are lying excuses. He is innocent. He is unreliable. A man of loose character. A option is correct. Those are lying excuses. Number 9. What did Herbert feel? A grace of personality, shame and disgrace to his self-esteem and character. Truthful, trustworthy. B option is correct. Shame and disgrace to his self-esteem and character. Number 10. What were the last words of Herbert uttered before his death? A piece of string, by my words of honor, I did not lie. Manana is a liar. I picked up pocketbook. I handed over the pocketbook to its owner. Correct option is A. A piece of string, by my word of honor, I did not lie. So this is all about the correct options. Now we will discuss the questions of the exercise. Why did Manana accuse Herbert of picking the lost pocketbook? So answer is, Manana accused Herbert because he had seen him picking something from the ground. He thought that the old man had picked up the pocketbook. Number 2. What did the people think of Herbert when they heard the return of the pocketbook by some other person? Answer is, people did not believe the old man's statements. They said that those were the lying excuses. Rather, they started to tell the story of the string to amuse themselves. Number 3. Why did George give the pocketbook to his employer? As George did not know how to read and write, he was an illiterate person, so he gave the pocketbook to his employer so that he might convey it to its owner. Number 4. What made Herbert shameful? People considered the old man to be a liar. This made him shameful. He said that there was nothing so shameful as to be called a liar. Number 5. Why did the people make fun of his innocence? The old man was poor countryman. People neither respected him nor believed him to be innocent. They rather began to make fun of his innocence to amuse themselves and did not believe his story of piece of string. Number 6. Why did he keep claiming his innocence till his death? He was a man of honor. People considered him to be a liar. This hurt his soul. He wanted to be declared an honorable, honest man. Therefore, he kept on trying to prove his innocence till death. This is the exercise question. These are the exercise questions. From the additional questions, you have to do some important questions. Look at the important questions and prepare them too. Further, you have to do the translation of the chapter once again, because in the paper you have to solve the पैसेज ऑफ 15 मार्क्स इनटू उर्दू. सो डू द ट्रांसलेशन वेरी केयरफुली. हियर आई एम गिविंग यू द सेकेंड पैसेज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर फॉर द ट्रांसलेशन एंड यू हैव टू डू इट एंड देन सेंड मी इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप एंड द अदर सेक्शंस विल सेंड देयर द ट्रांसलेशन एंड द आंसर्स ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस टू देयर टीचर्स. दिस वॉज द सेकेंड दिस इज द सेकेंड पैसेज विच यू हैव टू translate. There were chickens, pigeons and legs of mutton and you have to do it up to the his purchases and sales. Okay, it is all about today's revision. Allah Hafiz.